Hi, my name is Emma, and I just showered, so let's talk about books. Okay, so today I'm doing the Joy of Christmas book tag. I found it on the channel Go With Flick, because I was looking for a Christmas-themed book tag that I could do. So the first question is anticipation. The Christmas excitement is real. What book release or releases are you most anticipating? I didn't plan something out for this question, so off the top of my head, Cassandra Clare is doing another one of her collections, like The Vane Chronicles and The Shadowhunters Academy. And I always really like those collections because you get to know the characters through short stories. And that's just, it's fun. And I really like that world. It holds a special place in my heart. Question two. Christmas songs and carols. What book or author can you not help but sing its praises? For this one, I picked The Gentleman's Guide to Vice and Virtue by Mackenzie Lee. I read this over the summer and I loved it. It's so good. It's got LGBT representation in it, and that is amazing. And the girl in it is so badass. I love her. She's amazing. I didn't know if I was gonna like it a lot when I first picked it up, but then I read it and I'm in love with it, and I cannot wait for another book. Number three, Gingerbread Houses. What book or series has wonderful world building? I picked two for this because these are my two favorite worlds in anything ever. The first one is The Lunar Chronicles. It's really interesting. It's retellings of fairy tales with spacey themes involved. It's futuristic and it's got spacey stuff, and there's a lot of world building, and it's so interesting. And every book introduces a new character who lives in a different place, and every book adds on to the world, and it's just so good. I love it so much. And the other series that I really like the world building of is the Shadowhunters books. The world in this is so complex. There's so many different parts to it, and it's really interesting, and the characters are good, and again, LGBT representation is in this, and that's amazing. But the world in this is so interesting. It starts in the 1800s, and it goes all the way to present day, and that's so cool because you get to see the past of this world, and you get to see the present of this world, and you get to see all different types of characters deal with the concepts in this world, and it's so cool. I just love it. Number four, A Christmas Carol. Favorite classic or one that you want to read? If I'm going with my favorite classic, I'm gonna pick one of the only classics that I've read, which is To Kill a Mockingbird by Harper Lee. I read this my sophomore year in high school. I really liked it. Also, I was in the play of this at my school, so that was pretty cool. I was Miss Maudie, which was fun. But then, if I'm going with classic that I want to read, it's A Christmas Carol by Charles Dickens. I'm thinking that I'm gonna start this one tomorrow because Zoe from Read by Zoe is doing a readathon tomorrow, and I'm doing that as part of my Vlogmas. So number five is Christmas Sweets. What book would you love to receive for Christmas? I'm gonna say the three books that I asked for this year, which is Lord of Shadows by Cassandra Clare, Beastly Bones by William Ritter, whatever the second book is after The Jewel by Amy Ewing. I still don't know how to say her name. Six, Candles in the Window. What book gives you that warm, fuzzy feeling? For this one, I picked To All the Boys I've Loved Before by Jenny Han. I read this summer. And I didn't think I was gonna like this book at all because it's a contemporary young adult book, and I'm not the biggest fan of those until I read this book, and then all of a sudden I was like on a contemporary craze. This book is really good because the family in it is just so tight-knit and so special. It's a good book. It's a feel-good book. It makes me happy. Number 7 is Christmas Trees and Decorations. What are some of your favorite book covers? For this one, I picked two books. The first book that I picked is We Are Okay by Nina LaCour. Not only is this an excellent book filled with so many emotions, but the cover is beautiful. Okay, so we've obviously had a change in scenery because my mom went to bed and her room is right next to me, so I had to move. I really like that there's like the two colors. It's really cool because it's got like the contrast of like her bedroom and then like what I think is like the ocean, kind of mixed with like the night sky, and it's the book. It's really matches the book. And it also has on the inside cover this, which I think is her campus. Also, if you can hear meowing, that's our cat. It's Kitty Happy Hour. But my other favorite book cover is Secrets for the Mad by Dodie. But like, this book cover is so cute. It's got like all the little daisies around it, and it's got Dodie with her ukulele wearing a cute little dress. And then on the back, it's got like the back of Dodie with her little ukulele. It's very nice, and like the cursive writing for the title, it's just very nice. And not only is the cover beautiful, but the inside is beautiful as well. I forget what the last question title is, but I'm pretty sure that the last question is, what are some of your favorite Christmas memories? Come here. This is Astro. He's a baby. He's upset that I'm holding him. He's so cute. He wants to go. Okay. I love you. But my favorite Christmas memories, one of them is going to Chicago with my family. We used to only go to Chicago like once or twice a year. And one of the times was always to go look in the windows at Macy's and see the big Christmas tree. And, you know, I really enjoy that. Oh, I have another Christmas memory that I really like. This one started in high school. It started my freshman year in high school. I'm actually wearing a t-shirt for it right now. It's Ye Olde Christmas Feast. I did it for all 4 years. The first 2 years, I played the recorder with some of my really close friends, and it was really fun. Like, we sat in a corner and we just played when they were like serving food and stuff, and I really enjoyed it. And then the third year that I did it, I became a Lord's Lady, which is a singing group, and it's just girls. Which is why Lord's Ladies. It's a small group of girls who sings a few songs. I think we had two sets, and then we sang carols at the end of the feast, which is nice. And then the last year that I did it, I was a madrigal singer, which is the main event of the feast. And it was really exciting because it's a special thing, you know. And I loved it. It was so much fun. And I miss it so much. It's actually happening this weekend. I really want to go to it, but the tickets for it cost so much. They're like $40 a ticket. I don't have that kind of money to go watch a show and eat food or get served food that I can't eat because I don't eat meat and like most of the food is meat. So anyway, that's it for this video. That is the end of Vlogmas day 5. So, I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm gonna go. I think I might make cookies now, so bye.